our next speakers are two gentlemen who interoperate very well with each other. They were instrumental to rolling out the first cloud-native Open RAN 5G network in the US. Please welcome with me to the stage, Marc Rouanne and Greg Manganello. Thank you very much.
Marc, let's talk a little bit about our experiences. You're deploying a nationwide, cloud-native 5G O-RAN network in the States. What can you tell us about when you have to make your technology choices?
Yeah, thank you, Greg. We've been lucky. You know, we started a couple of years ago, and everybody knows we are deploying a greenfield across the U.S. So when you have a greenfield, of course, you can make different decisions. And we decided that our 5G should be different, that there was the possibility to go well beyond smartphones and go for what we call human interactions, machine to machines. And so we decided to build a cloud native 5G standalone network across the US. And then we made another big decision. We said it had to be Open RAN across the network again.
Right.
So here we are building and building every day.
And what's your vision for how you're going to interact with enterprises?
Yeah, so once we have this nationwide network, of course, cloud native and Open RAN allow us to consume software on demand and have the flexibility to pretty much define all those sort of networks. So the way we see Open RAN, I hear a lot of feedback that maybe the maturity is not there. What I'll give you some simple examples. When we take two vendors on the 7.2 interface, it takes about 4 weeks to integrate. Integrating on top of the virtualization layer that Anusan was mentioning takes about 6 weeks to have carrier grade capabilities. So if the vendors want to cooperate, it's really fast. We have a vibrant ecosystem. We can choose hardware, we can choose software. And we see the capabilities of the existing networks comparable to the speed and the stability that we're experiencing.
And how close is the cloud going to be to the towers? What's your vision? How's that going to be architected?
Well, actually, we've pushed the software, the cloud software, all the way down to the towers. So at the bottom of the tower, we have IT hardware. We have Kubernetes. Everything is on Kubernetes. So we have, apart from the radio units, all the software we have is containerized, real time on Kubernetes across the network, across thousands of sites. So it's a reality. You can run 5G on Kubernetes today on Intel-based hardware.
What can you tell us about the radios, Marc, the RUs?
So the radios, because we're Open RAN, we wanted to make a decision to have very dense radios. And we selected Fujitsu a couple of years back, because at the time, that was the smallest footprint. And Fujitsu has an extraordinary track record in terms of quality. And for us, because we have Open RAN, we want to make sure we never climb the towers again. Because we can change the software at the bottom as much as we want. So then you need to make sure that you climb to the tower once in your life, and that's it. And we needed a very high quality, very dense capability. And we got Fujitsu from that 2 years ago.
And how important is multi-band to you as part of your strategy?
So we're putting two radios per sector and for five bands. Mm-hmm. So actually we have dual band and triple band radios for low band and mid band, which, I mean, it's a dream for engineering the network because we have those five bands that are empty today and we can play with different propagation models and capabilities between the bands. And that's it's really a luxury that we love very much.
And how can you access the different ecosystems, like the silicon ecosystem and the software ecosystem over time? What's your vision for that?
So we have, since we started, the ecosystem has changed. So we now have access to a lot of silicon, a lot of accelerators. I'm sure you're going to see tons of it here that can power the Open RAN, both at the radio and at the hardware, bottom. What it meant to us when we selected our Open RAN radios is that actually we got the smallest size factor in the world for those dual band, triple band. And now that we have thousands of sites, people are watching, and we are often with our competitors on the same towers, and the difference in terms of size and is just so visible. And Open RAN allowed us to do that. So it's cheaper, wind load is much lower, much more efficient radios when it comes to power consumption, so better cost, lower lease costs. And you can really see it. You see it like, wow, this is DISH, because it's much simpler.
Right. So a different spot on the tower, and the leases are cheaper.
Yeah, and smaller. And smaller. Yeah.
That's good. And some of the other speakers, of course, talked about the mix and match feature. But where are you on the journey? I know you continuously select and trial. So tell us a little bit about the mix and match.
Well, we made a bet 2 years ago. We decided that we would only buy software from the telco industry. So apart from the radios, everything else we buy is software. And then we decided that software should never be tied to the hardware.
Mm.
So if you succeed in doing that, which we succeeded, then you can change the software like you want. So the way our business model is built with our vendors is that it's on demand. So we buy the software on demand when we need it, where we need it. And if we change our mind, and we have been changing our mind a few times based on the use cases and the requirements we had for certain markets, then we can just do it, which is a dream for an operator, right? You can, there is no so much discussion about you get that market and you get, no, today you have that market, tomorrow you have another one.
Right.
And for that use case and for that other use case. And it fosters innovation, competition, everybody is on their toes, you can try things, it's a new world.
I was about to say, because you're keeping us on our toes, but you're really keeping your whole ecosystem on the toes. And so how does that increased competition really help DISH Networks?
Well, we have full visibility and transparency between our vendors, as you know. It's an ecosystem where we share everything. Everybody sees the performance and the challenges of their partners. And that is really creating a lot of innovation.
Mm-hmm.
If people have ideas, they support each other, they accelerate. So we have seen our vendors really collaborate in a way that we've never seen in the telco before. We share logs, we share data, and that flexibility to tune the capabilities between the vendors and the ecosystem is just creating an acceleration of the innovation. We have ideas every day. As an engineer, I'm like, I never thought we could do that. And so the ideas come on top of the ideas, and every time, like, actually, we can do that. And that's fascinating. It's just your brain that is the limiting factor now. And
the knowledge is kind of increasing more and more, and we're sharing it across vendors. And so how are you capturing some of those, like, golden configurations and things that work?
Yeah, so that's the next big thing for us. Because we're deploying at scale, we need to, do parameterization and testing at scale. So we are putting automation, and we are putting also machine learning on top, because one of the beauty of Open RAN that people have not yet captured is the fact that everything can be observed, is visible. And in the world of cloud native, if you can observe, then you can put the cloud and the analytics on top, and then you become 10 times smarter.
Right.
What we're finding is that what the complexity of what we're doing is way beyond man. Capabilities, human capabilities. So we need the machines to help us with augmented intelligence, because we can see everything, down to the Kubernetes pod, down to the scheduler. We see everything. You put that in data lakes, you put analytics, and then you see correlation, and that we'd never thought of.
Right.
So it's a learning, feast every day.
Right. I think it's like you explained to me, learning accelerating. Because the data lake is looking at all the, and now we can put analytics on top, so now we can really learn.
Yeah.
So that's great. So I think that's our presentation.
Well, thanks. And
thanks
for your support with and all our vendors that have really made that story happen. And I mean, that has been a dream to work with our partners. Thank you, Greg.
Thank you, Mark.